Another question that I get pretty often is this: should an aspiring data scientist learn more about big data, like Apache Hadoop or Spark, to get a job? And I will keep this short and sweet. The answer is no. Generally speaking, learning about big data is not needed to get a junior data scientist position. And in this episode, I will tell you why. Hi, I'm Toby Mester, and this is the Data 36 Data Science Podcast. So, I have three simple reasons why you shouldn't learn more about big data right now if you are an aspiring data scientist. Let me see this one by one. The first one is the most important one. Big data usually is the field of data engineers. Let's take a look at this chart about different data science positions at a company. Well, if you are listening to the podcast version of this episode, check out the show notes for the picture. If you are watching it on YouTube, you can see the chart right now. So the blue bubbles show the typical steps of a data science project. The green rectangles are the different data positions associated with these steps. The point is that the different steps of a data science project require different levels of programming and engineering skills. If we follow the generally used naming conventions, a data scientist, especially a junior data scientist, will mostly work on the tasks from the right side of this chart, that's data cleaning, analytics, visualization, and helping with decision making. And the tasks on the left side are more like the field of data engineers. These tasks are setting up data collection, figuring out the best way to store the data, and generally speaking, building the data infrastructure. And the problems that big data solutions like Apache Hadoop or Spark answer are part of the data infrastructure related problems. So all in all, it means that for you, as an aspiring data scientist, big data won't be interesting for now, except if you in fact would rather become a data engineer. Which is a pretty cool position too, but it's a more technical job. Just a quick comment here, you should know that in the data field, the different naming of different positions is pretty messy. Thank you, dear creative HR specialists. There are data engineers, big data specialists, machine learning ninjas, AI gurus, and so it's pretty hard to say that there is a strict rule about who we can call a data scientist and who we can't. But I see a pattern in the people who have asked this original question, and so if you follow the most common naming conventions for data positions and you ask whether you should learn about big data to get a junior data scientist position, the answer will be no. And here's my second reason. You can learn big data on the job. Get back to the original question. Should I learn about big data to get a junior data scientist position? Asking this implies that you already have some basic knowledge on the topic. And that might be more than enough to get your first position. Data science is an ever-changing field, and nobody expects that you know everything in it. If you have the solid foundations of Python, SQL, statistics, and business thinking, you can learn the rest later, on the job. I mean, it's totally possible that you will start to work for a company where, after all, you will have to start to use Apache Spark, for instance. But if so, don't worry, you can learn that on the job, and the data engineers at the company will most probably help you to get up to speed too. And I can guarantee, if you were able to learn coding in Python and SQL, you will be able to learn big data languages too. And here is reason number three, you can take advantage of your Python, SQL, and pandas knowledge in Apache Spark too. Even if you have to work with a big data language, like Apache Spark on the job, it's good to know that it has a Python API, a module called Spark SQL, a solution to use pandas data frames, and many other useful layers. Find links for these in the show notes. But the point is that this means that sure, to be able to use, for instance, Apache Spark, you have to learn a bit more, but you will be able to take advantage of your pre-existing Python, SQL, and pandas knowledge in big data systems too. Okay, let's wrap up this episode. Should you learn more about big data for junior data scientist role? Well, in an ideal world, of course, you would learn everything before you apply to your first job. But in the real world, that would take long, long years, and you don't have that much time. So it's best if you focus on the fundamental skills for now, mastering SQL, Python, Bash, the basics of statistics and business thinking. And if you have more time, you can go into the different specifications, like big data. But if we are being realistic here, that will most likely happen on the job. And that's just fine. With that being said, this is the end of this episode. If you liked it, please subscribe, leave a rating or a comment. And remember, the best way to get notified about new episodes is always the Data36 newsletter list, the only place where I really communicate to my audience right now. You can subscribe to it at data36.com/newsletter. And hey, if you do so, you will get access to a lot of free learning materials too, including my free mini course called How to Become a Data Scientist. Anyways, thank you for listening. I'm Tommy Mester from data36.com. Until next time.